My name is Nkamuheleng Benvelio. Some people call me Ben. My family is a bit complicated because my dad passed away when I was really, really young. And then I had to be adopted by my aunt and who raised me from an early age until I was a young adult. So as I stayed with my aunt, I think it was in 2005, if I remember clearly, she found someone new, someone that made her happy, and he happened to be a pastor. So that kind of put a strain in my life in a way, because I had to have certain changes in life just to respect the church and everything else that he was doing. I needed to be at church every Sunday, make sure I'm at church, dress up in a specific way, change from being comfortable into being the way they think it's comfortable for me. So their clothes would be in the actual closet, and then my clothes would be in my secret closet, which is under the mattress, which is where everything else that I loved and made me happy would be. I had clothes that I would wear when I come out from the house, and I would look like a man. I saw myself as a man. In the bus, I literally sat every time in the back seat because I knew I have to change. So I would change into a different outfit. So I'd come out from home looking the way they want me to look, get to the bus or the transport that I was using to get to school, and then dress up in a way that I felt comfortable. If I felt like we're wearing skinny jeans today and we discussed that with friends, I would be wearing my skinny jean, the brightest, with a different t-shirt, different design, which we initially make for ourselves, and go to school. So my life had to be a double life. When I get to school, I'm a different person. When I come back home, I need to change again and look like the way I left the house and be a different person. My aunt, who happens to be my mom, initiated that my bed be moved differently so that it face a different direction. Just a new style to surprise me when I come back from school. So they found my clothes under the mattress as they were lifting up the bed, and it was a lot of clothes, I must say. So it was a problem. When I got back, I was told to go get a stick that is my size so that they will beat me up with it. I didn't understand why. So I went out and got it. I didn't take it seriously, put it on the table. Then they were asking me questions, and I was told to be very careful when I answer the questions. What is it that I'm wearing? What are those clothes? Where are they from? They found it very disrespectful for the image that, the title that my uncle was having, and the way I dressed up and looked. Things were taken away from me. I was treated differently. I was now not allowed to wear civvies. I'd rather wear school clothes. I was monitored most of the times, checking up on me at school right there and then. How was my performance? Like, my whole lifestyle changed from having the freedom that I had to being controlled into how they preferred me to be. And church stopped being only on Sunday. Church went on from Wednesday, Friday, youth, Saturday, choir practice, Sunday, the actual service. So everything changed. Everything became harder on me. I couldn't have friends who were girls anymore because they were actually the ones that were confusing me into what I was turning into. I wanted to be more girly, so they said. So I tried taking my life, and I ended up in hospital because I took tablets, pills, headaches and allergies. It was just a lot of variety of pills. Things became easier for a while, but it didn't last long. It was just for my recovery so that I felt better. It went back to that. It was easier, but it was not different from how my lifestyle was. And then my uncle passed away in 2012, I think, if not 13. And it put an ease on my life because I was now able to go back into the lifestyle and the things that I preferred. And then I also started varsity. Varsity was the best place. I literally changed my formal trousers. I cut it into half the way I wanted it. Friends showed me how to redesign clothes. You found people that were comfortable and doing things that make them happy. And in a way, that's where I got comfort into being who I am and doing everything else that made me happy. Changing, wearing the way I want, from formal to being the Ben that I am today, Benvelio. My name is Benvelio, and I am a proud young hero.